What is up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we are going to be talking about David Blau, the Detroit Lions' third string quarterback. Now, I'm going to try to get right to the point on this video because I've done this multiple times, but the videos come out really, really long. So I want to try to get right to the point. That way it's not like a 30-minute video because I don't know if anybody wants to see that. If you guys do like those kind of episodes, though, the podcast is for you. So click the link in the description and go to the podcast, man. I think it's the perfect time to plug it. But we're talking about David Blau today. Now, I think a couple of days ago, maybe about a week ago now, I put out a poll. I said, do you want to see a Matthew Stafford video or a David Blau video? Now, Matthew Stafford won overwhelmingly, but in the back of my mind, I was like, a David Blau video could be very, very interesting. And I'm glad we are doing that today. The 6'1", 205-pound quarterback out of Purdue is who we're going to be focusing on today. Now, we're going to kind of fly through his college days because I really want to focus on what he did with the Lions last season because he's with the Lions now. You know, forget about all the college stuff. At this point, he's with the Lions. Let's worry about what he did in our season. So I think it makes sense to focus on that because we actually do have clips of him playing in regular season games. So we'll focus on those. But at the same time, we will touch on his college days a little bit. So I'll give you a quick little recap of who David Blau is, where he's from, what he did. So David Blau was an undrafted free agent back in 2019 who was picked up by the Browns. And the Detroit Lions traded for David Blau from the Cleveland Browns. Now, I think a lot of people think that was just because of the Browns preseason game. However, when I went back and looked, it turns out the Lions quarterback coach at the time was very interested in David Blau. And he attended his pre-draft workout and said that everything went really well. He looked like a leader on the field. He was good on the field. His play was good. He had a nice touch on the football. And then when they came to the intelligence side of things, if you guys go watch Cardinals videos on, you know, their pre-draft stuff, you'll get to see a lot of this. But when, you know, they ask him questions and then they come back to it, can he remember it? You know, how intelligent is he? It all came out really well, and they were really interested in him. Then they played the Browns in the preseason. They probably liked a little bit more then, and all of a sudden the Browns put him available, and they're like, let's go get him. And they went and got him. So he is now our third-string quarterback. And the question is, can David Blau be our future? Can David Blau be the future starter for the Lions? And I know it's far out to say that now, and I'm not going to necessarily make a prediction here, but I will say this. I've had this question asked me before, and I will say this. The best chance David Blau has to be a starter with the Lions at some point is if Matthew Stafford, Matt Patricia, and Bob Quinn are successful. If that is the case, Matthew Stafford will stick around until at least the end of his contract, maybe longer. He'll be able to continue to groom a guy like David Blau. Chase Daniel is here for 3 years who can help him from the sideline, and if anything does happen, he can step in instead of David Blau. So now you got two veterans that can teach, you know, David Blau what he needs to know about the NFL, continue to help him get better, you know, kind of quietly in the background. And at the same time, you know, it's not like everything's going to be up in the air. See, if the Lions aren't successful, we don't know what's going to happen because Matt Patricia and Bob Quinn are gone. The next regime comes in and they're going to try to change everything. They may not want David Blau's play style. They may look for a new quarterback, which will end up putting everything into the air. So if that is the case, that's not good for David Blau, or at least it may not be good for David Blau's future. So his best chance is to have Stafford be successful, continue to learn behind him, and at some point, the Lions say, hey, David Blau's ready to go, and he takes over. Now, why do we have confidence that that could be the case? Well, Bob Quinn has said that he likes to draft a quarterback every year, and that's because you want to try to find your future one in the late rounds without using an early round pick. That's great, but the last 2 years, he hasn't done that, and David Blau is coming back for his second year. So maybe he really does like David Blau and what he saw on the field, and I'm going to be honest with you. If you go look at his stats, you're going to be like, that's not that good. But at the same time, if you go look at any rookie quarterback stats, you're going to be like, oh, that's not good. Matthew Stafford stats as a rookie, not good. Tom Brady stats, not very good. Not bad, not very good. When you look at Peyton Manning stats, that's awful. That's awful. And those are great quarterbacks. And when you look at David Blau, not great, but not bad. Not bad. Actually arguably better. But again, his team was probably better than Stafford's team. Stafford was in an absolute mess. Holy cow. But when I went back and watched him, and this is, I think, was his first game here versus the Bears. Thanksgiving game, you know, Bears are known to have a good defense. They're going to get pressure. They're going to try to make him uncomfortable. And I'm going back and watching, and I'm like, this dude looks really good. Like, he doesn't look uncomfortable whatsoever. So I want to do a video on him. I'm not even going to touch on his college stats or anything like that. I'm literally going to just, you know, get past all that. The one thing I will say is that the major con coming out of college was his inaccuracy at times. And when you watch him, he got better at that towards the end of his career. His numbers got a lot better. He got help from Jeff Brohm, who was a coach there at the time, made him a lot more accurate, made him more consistent. He started taking deeper shots, 8.1 yards per attempt. Numbers went way up. You can just look him up on your own. I just don't want to touch on that because I want to get right to the point. So, and he beat Ohio State. Let me just point that out there. That's a check mark for you. You're all of a sudden on my radar because of that. Now, let's talk about what I saw from the NFL. Let's go through the strengths and weaknesses quickly, and then we'll touch more on them as we watch the film. So the first strength is his ability to trust the offensive line. He's cool, he's collected, and he has confidence in his offensive line to protect him. You'll see with a lot of young quarterbacks, they're not confident. And I can understand why Matthew Stafford may not have been confident. Now, or a lot of running quarterbacks have that problem. I don't think Matthew Stafford had as much as some running quarterbacks, but usually it's because they don't necessarily trust the offensive line yet. However, David Blau didn't show me that. I mean, yes, he would, you know, scramble at times, but he seemed to have a lot of confidence. I mean, he would stand in there, take hits, stand in there, wait till the last minute, go through his progressions. That's a lot of confidence for an offensive line that's not the best, you know, good, not the best. I loved that out of a young player. I loved it. The next pro I would take away is his ability to step up in the pocket, okay? He can step up in the pocket and he can move. Now, he doesn't have mobility of Russell Wilson, Kyler Murray, but he does have enough ability to make plays happen. You'll see a great example and a couple of them in today's video. He does have that ability, and that's just something that every quarterback has. Some have it, some don't. And if you can utilize it and you're smart with it and you're able to stay healthy, it's a really big factor in football games. Doesn't have to be, you know, ability to be the fast player. Don't have to be Michael Vick, but that little bit of ability to get outside the pocket can definitely help. He can throw on the run pretty well. I think it's inconsistent at times, but, you know, who's not inconsistent throwing on the run? And again, he's young. You got to remember, I'm looking at these a little bit lighter than I would take a starter, because if I'm looking at a starter, I'm like, hey, you got to be balling out. I'm looking at David Blau, who's an undrafted player this year in 2019's draft. First year player for the Lions, kind of thrown into the fire. I got to be a little bit, you know, not as hard on him with some of the stuff that I take away. But I will take away some cons, because there are definitely our weaknesses. There's a reason he went undrafted, right? There's definitely a reason for that. And he was our third string quarterback, and he still is. He has a very good touch on the football. I love his touch on the ball. Look, doesn't have a rocket arm. I'm going to throw this weakness out there right now. Does not have a rocket, can't put the ball on the line, can't zip it. Maybe he gets better, maybe he gets stronger. But if you need a 20, 25-yard pass that's on a line, fit it in there, fit it into a hole, you know, start off your back foot like Stafford, give me a flick of the wrist, he ain't doing that for you. All right, you need a deep out route, you need him to catch and keep running. He's probably not your guy. Maybe he'll get better with that, but right now he's not. But if you need a 50-yard pass that's dropped into the basket, a great touch, this is that guy. And you're going to see his intelligence a lot, but he has, oh my gosh, great touch, beautiful touch. For his age, beautiful touch. I love it. And his pocket awareness. Now, he has some pocket awareness. I would say one major kind of takeaway from this is, yes, he can feel the pressure. He's always able to feel pressure, which is awesome. Even when he can't see it, he can feel it, and he knows when to get out of there. But I would also say sometimes he looks down, and he doesn't necessarily look up and see what the options are. But maybe that also could be him just trying to be more conservative. Knowing this is my first year, I'm not going to go out there and take 10 tons of chances. Now, let's talk about his weaknesses. Doesn't have that zip. Doesn't put that zip on the arm. You're going to see him time and time again. Like I said, against pressure, sometimes he looks down. But again, I think he is still really good at aware and knowing when the pressure is there. Maybe he'll be better with that, maybe more confident, continues to be with the Detroit Lions. It's inconsistent accuracy at times. You're going to see some great plays where it's like, wow, that's so good. It's a great pass. And there's the other plays where it's like, dude, where are you throwing the football? And you're going to see that right off the bat. So those are the pros and cons. We'll look more into it as we watch. But let's get into this film so this video doesn't take forever. Let's go! I know y'all want to see it. So the first player you're going to see here is basically an inside route here. I think this is TJ Hockenson in the slot and on top of your screen. And here you're going to see two examples. You're going to see one is kind of inaccurate, but two, it's not able to get there. And you're going to see he doesn't have that rocket. He can't rifle that ball in there. He underthrows it. Maybe he tried to do it strategically, but it's underthrown. It hits the ground, and he's not able to get it to his target. So you're going to see that is the first play we will see here. So the Bears bring a blitz. Excuse me. Lions pick it up. Great move to get inside. Confidence in his wide receiver. I love the read. He's like, man, he's inside. I'm making the throw. Great throw. Just underthrew it. So there's, you know, kind of a couple in a one. And so that's the first play. We're going to show good plays and bad plays. I want to show you guys both. This is the entire Chicago Bears game. I was expecting it to be tough for him. Very impressed. All right, now here's the bomb. This is the play that everybody knows. And this is Kenny Galladay at the bottom of your screen. He's going to score a touchdown here. Now, they're in a cover one, it looks like. And what you're going to see is the safety. He kind of steps up trying to take away a crossing route from Amendola. And it allows him to be one-on-one with Amukamara. And obviously, we all know, say it with me, that's not a good decision. And you're going to see it's a bomb. But again, this kind of shows you to me, he has the arm strength to throw it deep. If you want to need him to throw 60-plus, he can do it. He just isn't doing it on a rope. And you're going to see that here. I mean, this is, you know, this is having the arm strength. Steps up, you know, trust it. Hey, confidence in that pocket. Stay in the pocket. Didn't run out. Confidence to stay in his pocket. Go through his progression. See the deep route. Because if he leaves, he may not see that. Or even get a chance to throw it out there. Confidence steps up in the pocket. Throws it deep. Leaves it up there for Kenny Galladay. Great play. Great play. Next up, you're going to see, this may be the same play. But you're going to see some inaccuracies soon. This may be the same play. Oh, here's their inaccuracy. Okay, now this one, it looks like they were on a different page here. When I'm watching this one back, this one to me is on a different page. See, Amendola comes across the middle. You can see him already looking right. So it looks like he's trying to run like a zig route. And it looks like David Blau is throwing it right away. This may be miscommunication. This may be him trying to throw there before he leaves. But he tries to throw it inside. Amendola tries to leave and he tries to get back to it. And he's like, oh, snap. And it gets tipped into the air. So kind of a tough one there. That's just being young. I'm assuming it was miscommunication on what they were trying to do. So then you're going to see an accurate play. And then so there's good and there's bad. Then he hits you with this. Not the most exciting, but he's going to feel the pressure, dump it off to his running back, and put it in his hands. This is a good pass. The pressure is there, right? The pressure is on him. You can see Khalil Mack on the bottom. He gets him, and you can see the pressure behind. There comes pressure from the interior. Doesn't leave the pocket. Cool, collected, not panicking. Throws it out to his running back, and it ultimately leads to a first down, which is huge. which is huge. Just give him a chance. You know, don't give up on the play. Gives his wide receiver a chance. Gives Ty Johnson an opportunity to make play, and he does. He gets the first down. Look, let me pause it here. You can see Matt Patricia right here. I think this is Matthew Stafford right here. I just thought I'd point that out. Okay, cool. Sorry, I don't know what I'm pointing out. This is the best play I saw of the game. I was so impressed when I saw this. You're going to see, I don't know if this was planned, he was told to do this. Whether he was or wasn't, it's still smart. It played off perfectly. And this could be some Daryl Bevel magic. This could be some, you know, David Blau magic. I don't know. He does do magic tricks. You're going to see a pump fake, which ultimately is going to lead Clinton Dix, I believe that's the safety out there, to jump. And that pump fake gets him to jump, which allows Kenny to get to the inside on the corner, which makes it so the safety is late to get back, to squeeze the route, and it allows him to drop it in the breadbasket. This is probably the dottiest of dots you're going to see from David Blau right here. Watch this. So, boom, play action. I mean, not play action. Pump fake. Safety jumps. Took two steps. One step. One misstep. He jumps. Snap. I got to get back. You can see him trying to get back because he's looking deep. Too bad Galladay's an absolute speedster, man. Shakes him outside, gets the inside leverage, and now all of a sudden the safety's trying to work back, not able to get there in time, drops it in the basket, man. That's a dot. Not every quarterback's going to give you that. So that's a great play from Galladay and from Blau. So that's probably the best one I've seen. Here's another. I'm going to let you see this one because I think this one's a better angle of it because the last one's kind of blurry. You'll actually be able to see the football on this one. All right, so you're going to see here. So watch the safety up top. So he's kind of blocked your screen. All of a sudden, here's the fake. Watch him pop on your screen. Fake. Boom, he's on your screen. He kind of missteps. And look at this pass, man. Oh, my gosh. I don't even need to say nothing. Look at that pass. Now, obviously, Galladay's going to do his thing. Just a mismatch. So great play there. Now you're going to see some mobility. Pretty solid pass. It was a drop pass. Almost led to an interception. Nothing crazy here. Maybe he was in the pocket too long. Couldn't really go upfield because of the two linebackers lurking. So he tries to get to the outside. Sees Lois Thomas come across this field. So he fakes it there. Great fake again. You know, great fake. Gets to the outside. There's some mobility that, you know, I think that was holding on Taylor Decker, which you'll see killed us because you can see the ref is about to throw that freaking flag. Anyways, gets to the outside, and look at this pass, man. It's the only way you can throw it. You only can throw it above, and Logan, you got to catch that. You got to catch that. It almost leads to a pick, so whoa, you got to catch that, though. But again, a great job to have that ability. If you use it right, it can change the game. It can be an X factor, so that's huge. What else do we got next? Okay, here we go. Now, this is nice. A little bit of a step up, not necessarily too much, but again, pocket awareness, not freaking out, keeping his cool, able to set his feet and throw it down over the middle here. You're not going to see a zip. It's a little bit probably underthrown. Force the wide receiver to come back. I think it's Amendola over the middle, but watch this play. Okay, this is good stuff. Play action, right? Feels the heat behind him. Feels his heat. Can't see it. Feels it. Steps up a little bit. Little step up. And then again, throws a dot. Boom. Between the two linebackers to Amendola. That's a first down. Come on, man. That's Amendola being great and David Blau being great. I mean, this is literally good and bad. I'm watching like every play here. This is crazy. He showed me a lot of good things. He wasn't the perfect, but he showed me a lot of things that we can build on. Look at this. Step up, confident, throwing over the middle. Bop. Great stuff. Great stuff. All right. So that's really good. You're going to see an accurate pass here again. So watch McKissick. He comes across the screen. You're going to see a man-to-man. Linebacker tries to take it away. Obviously, you can't beat him there. So he trusts McKissick to beat him. Good throw. Great catch. Great catch. That's beautiful stuff. Then you're going to see his pocket presence, okay? Now, this isn't the most beautiful thing in the world, but he does get back to the line of scrimmage. And to me here, I think this is one of those plays where, okay, if he was looking downfield, he could have made a play, and this is where he misses receivers because maybe he has his head down. But at least he was able to recognize there was pressure without being able to see it. So play action, you know, his blind side, you know, Max coming. It kind of cut here, but Max coming. Okay, so Mac comes behind. He's able to step up in the pocket. And if you guys see, if you guys see right here, boom, Kenny Galladay, I think that's Galladay or Jones, is wide open. And right here, if he looks up, he can throw that across the field. Maybe he doesn't have that in his game. Maybe he's smart to just keep it, but he does get back to the line. So that's still athleticism to get back to the line and not have a negative play. So that's cool. Here you're going to see possibly an inaccurate pass. And again, you'll see those at times. Just a little bit underthrown. You know, it still was caught. It still did lead to a first down. But if he throws that in front of him, Hockenson can probably keep running. Not a terrible pass. Could have been better, though, because he does have a step. And if he throws that in front of him, maybe if he has more arm strike, maybe he's able to get it out there and Hockenson can make a bigger play. But they do signal a first down, so that's good stuff. Again, another dot here. Rolling to his right, throwing a dot, nearly underthrown, but still hits the comeback route. Good stuff. Again, rolling out. Here's on the run a little bit. Sets his feet, so he's not, like, kind of losing himself and just firing it. Sets his feet, okay, and puts a dot. Almost underthrown, but again, it's just enough. It's just enough to get by, and that's great. It's not like it holds him back. It's just enough to make plays, and he knows his strengths and weaknesses. He knows what he can and can't do, and he plays to that. You know, he's not going to throw passes that he doesn't make. Maybe that's why he didn't throw this one, because he's intelligent, he's smart. He knows what he can and can't do, so he knows his abilities. All right, let's get into this next one here. You're going to see again, this is, I think, the same play from another angle. No, this is the different play. Same kind of concept, though. So, again, in the gun, feels the pressure, you know, right? I mean, there's some behind him, but there's one right in front of his face. Doesn't leave, though. Stands in the pocket, stands his ground, confident, throws it, okay? Now, maybe if he throws this on the line, maybe he continues to run. Because if you hit him here, boom, and he catches that, he might be able to get to the edge. But again, it's a little lofty. He's not able to do that. But it's still a good play. It's still a big play for the Lions. So I think this is the last one you will see. Now, this one is where if you can use mobility, if you can stay healthy and you don't overdo it, but you're smart with it, it can be a game changer. Because this is a big play. It was either a third or fourth down. Lions need to get the first. And because he can run, he's able to escape Khalil Mack. Who would have thought? Get off of me. Which LSP was a play, which I think came back us, so that's great. But get us to the outside. Hockenson, let's go there. He's able to get the first down. That could be a game changer, all right? He showed us some great things, showed us some cons, but overall, I think David Blau could be the future for the Lions. I'm really excited after I started to watch him. Definitely go check him out if you haven't. There's definitely some bad, but there's also some stuff to work on, and there's also some stuff to build on. Thank you for watching, and I'm out. Oh, and go check out the Dodcast. The link is in the description. Come on, man. I'm out.